Do you feel the pulse? All right. This is your boy Loco from Crypto coming to you today with some just information on the crypto world, man. All the some of the stuff that be happening with some of these things going on, Lupex, bro. Like that for real? For real? You know, that current situation that just happened today, I was going to talk about some other things, man, but it ain't right, man. I mean, a lot of you who invested in this company, man, you did it with your hard-earned money. You went in there, you know, you were given an opportunity to make all your money, man. These people are scums, bro. And at the end of the day, there's going to be a certain place for those type of people, because I think the Oracle even had a video with a man sitting there having an interview, and a dude actually sitting there knowing at the end of the day, their goal was to walk out on some of you people. Bro, if we can only understand what people think at sometimes, bro, probably would have smashed them right there, man. You know, and that's wrong. And that's just the wrong thing to just do, man. I mean, and I'm going to show you guys a little bit later, for the amount of money that they ran for was penny change for what they could have earned. Because it wasn't just one man. It wasn't just Team Us promoting this. You had the whole community. They duped everybody. Obviously, everybody's going to point the finger to the big dog. And that's whatever, you know. That's why he's there. He takes the bullets. He'll take them. He'll dish them. That's what he does. You know, and Team Us, man, we got to support this situation, because at the end of the day, it was everybody. It was everybody. It wasn't just man. This man over here posted the first video. And where's everybody at? Everybody who told everybody to invest. You're still sitting here. It's almost 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And there's probably only like 5 videos when hundreds of you were out there promoting it. You know, but that's not even the point, because it's not even about us. Because at the end of the day, even though we were promoting and we had good intentions, we gave them our money. You guys gave them your money. I didn't get a chance to get it because I wasn't even around that time in those lending platforms when they came out in January. So even though you guys were promoting it out there, obviously you got to own it up. Talk to your people that you with. Let them know, you know what? You know, the strategies that we work in Team Us is understanding that we don't put everything in one investment. We understand we spread it out, because it only takes one ICO to make up for everything, And we're evolving a lot more than we were a month ago, because a month ago, like you said, we've been dealing with this garbage in December. And the game was completely different in December when that was happening. And now, as you see with these new coins, with Thorncoin, I don't even want to put Thorncoin with this coin right now with Lupex. The way Thorncoin is doing things right now, and I'm going to show you why I feel very confident why these people won't pull a stupid stunt like that, because the upside potential is nothing. It's everything compared to what if they would walk out on us right now. And I'll show you, some numbers. So I don't even want you guys to ever put Thorncoin with this Lupex or with these coins that are just going to run out, you know, because they're very communicative. And look, The hype. If you guys bought this coin in the ICO phase, I guarantee you were rejected 2 or 3 times. That's how crazy you couldn't get this coin on the 50 cents round. Who bought on the 50 cents round? And if you didn't, it's because you got a red button like rejected, like I did. Got rejected on a 70 cents round. Got rejected on a 90 cents round. Over here, waking up in the morning, I know your finger was like this trying to buy that coin. So don't put Thorncoin on this level, because Thorncoin, I'm telling you, has a lot of potential. And where they're going and what they're trying to do, it's going to make up for everything. Lupex, who after Thorncoin when you make this money? And they know that. And if they didn't know about this space, Thorncoin, how great would it be you put a message out here to tell these people about Thorncoin, tell them how you feel, and let them know that you're not this company that want to come over here and take advantage of people, because you know the upside of potential of Thorncoin is huge. No one talks anything about negative about Thorncoin, because they're doing everything right. You know, so I definitely had to let that off of my chest, but I want to show you some context with it, you know, because I was going to sit here and I was going to tell you about the lending strategy that I'm going to do, but I'll do that in a few days, because we have till the 18th for the internal exchange open up, and now it's game time. And now it's time to sit down, because I really feel this is going to come through, you know, because you know what? They said the same thing about DeVore, and DeVore came through. Obviously, you saw the ending of it, but a lot of people made money in DeVore. You know, Rego Coin, whatever, came through. It's not here no more. It's on life support, but it made a lot of people amount of money. And Thorncoin could be put on that level, and Thorncoin can make a lot of money. And they are in a better position than any of these coins could have ever made. They're in a better position than DeVore. They're in a better division in Regal, and they have a better support system and a better hype than anything you can batter with a low amount of supply. So I don't even want to put Thorn Corn anything next to Lupek and all these other people that want to run and dump on this corn. But I want to show you something. So I was sitting here and I was like, you know what? Let me put some numbers together. Let me try to understand why these people did what they did and why I feel at the end of the day, Thorn Corn, for them to even pull one of these Lupeks would be so stupid. It makes no sense. It just be dumb. It just be mind-boggling if these people over here trying to make $1 million when they can make 100 mil. Like, who the hell is making these decisions? And this could have happened to Lupex, because I'm gonna show you the amount of money that Lupex left with, approximately, and what they could have done, because they had the whole community of freaking YouTube with them, and they dumped on a stupid. What were they? Let's go. So I went over here. Obviously, you can't see anything for Lupex right now. It's all blocked out. They ran and gone. All right, Twitter page down. But I tried to do some research on their white paper, and there was still some YouTube video out. I was able to pause it and see what they were all about. They had a Christmas sale, all right, at 35 cents, all right? This was in Christmas in December. At 175,000 they raised. They went from 1.2 million. They started that on January 3rd, and it was at 400, and they raised 411,000. These are all the coins that they sold on the round. They went to 80 cents at a mil, 90 cents at 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, and 1.8 at $1, $1.10, and $1.20. I put everything total together. It came out to 7,786,000, approximately right there, that they raised in total in Bitcoin. And a little bit of Ethereum, because I think you could have bought in Ethereum. And correct me if I'm wrong. But about $7 million, about $8 million, okay? But Bitcoin at that price was 15.5, okay? It was close to 16,000, 15 and a half grand was Bitcoin on January 3rd when this whole thing started. Bitcoin right now, 8,200. It's literally almost half of the value of what they had. So if you were to take, and I did it right here, if you were to take the 7 million and you divide that in half, they had close to about $3.8 million, okay? And this was in January. Now, you got to think they were probably paying some people. You could probably think they were running this support staff, whatever they were trying to do, or if it takes money to run these websites or to create these type of pamphlets, you're probably thinking they spent 800,000, maybe a mil, you know, because I'm thinking that they were low on cash. That's why they pulled this little last minute stunt where you can you please send me your BTC? Please straight up more. Can you give me more? Trying to dump up coins for like no value, you know? Because I feel like they were at their last straw, like, hey, let's try to raise a little bit more money, because they really probably didn't even run off with much money, because half of their money since Bitcoin at the price of Bitcoin at 8.2 dropped at 3.8, you know? So they were running with whatever they can, and whether they're going to sell all the Bitcoin or they're going to sit in an account and hope Bitcoin goes up, we don't know. But at this approximate moment, they barely ran with anything. And they had so much potential. And they had so much potential to make so much money, because they had a lot of YouTubers behind them to make more. So what are you doing running away with half of the money that you raised? $3 million. So stupid. And there's a special place for you. There's a special place for people like you, you know? But I sit here and I look at Thorn Coin, okay? And I look at a coin at about approximately 9 million coins, all right? I did the rounds with Thorn Coin. I did it at the 50 cents, the 70 cents, the 80, going up that way. They raised 5,700,000. That in itself, it's not even a lot of money, $5 million, okay? But what's really cool about the price of Bitcoin wasn't really that low compared to Lupex, where it dropped in half. If you look at the price of Bitcoin, where it was at when they started, was at 10.5, and the current price right now is about 8,200. It's a couple thousand dollars less when the money is embedded. So you're probably looking at something where they're about 5 million, a little bit under 4 million. You know, they had the top servers. You can see that they revamped their whole stake, and that costs money to go on in there to change all these things, to communicate with the people. I mean they are on top of their game, you know, and they're only sitting at $4 million. Why does a company want to walk away with $4 million when Thorn Coin at the end of the day has nothing but hype? It has nothing but hype, and everything that they're doing is good. The potential of this coin going up to $100, $200, $300 is very, very powerful, you know, and they know that, and I think they know that. And I think in the crypto world, it's like it was talked about in the crypto world, it's like gambling. And I think Thorn Coin likes to gamble, you know, and they're going to put their money up front. And they're going to put their money up front because, honestly, in today's time, what is 3 million? What is 4 million, man? we can make some really good money. They know they can make some great money. And I really feel confidence in this coin. And I feel that there's so much potential, man. They open up their stake. And I know, look, I love you, Chrysos. And we're going to wait for you to get your act together. But Thorncoin, it made no mistake. CoinThor paid everyone here 100%. I ain't hear nobody in Thorncoin talk about them not getting their stake in their coins. And they got it back, boom, on that same day with this same amount. And then when you put it back in there, go right now into your Thorncoin account and you already accumulated. And I guarantee you on that 18th or the 16th, 17th, you get your coin back, boom, you're going to get it. And I know long-term staking is going to be good, you know, to lend and have that money. I believe very strongly that they're going to be paying your interest. And when they start doing that and everything starts hitting and binging and hitting and hitting and everything starts going well, this coin's going to rise. And we're going to forget about Lupex. So I definitely want to come out with you guys, you know, to just stay confident. I know there's a lot of people right now just pissed off. You know, if you put a lot of money in there that you shouldn't invest it in, you know, that's something that you need to understand. On Team Us, we don't do that. And you know what? A lot of Team Us members right now, yeah, we understand we lost some money, but we ain't complaining. We ain't flipping a script like half of these people. Anytime you hear something right now, these are people that are fools, man. These are people that want to go over there complaining, want to blame it on somebody else, but not themselves. They are fools because they didn't first follow this. They're not from Team Us. They're just a bunch of haters. They're just a bunch of haters understanding that the way we do this business, the way we do business moving forward in Team Us, we understand we have multiple platforms for this reason. And we understand we don't put everything in one platform. We spread it out, understanding that the possibility is going to be higher to hit one. And when one hits, makes up for everything that you lost. So I know that's not Team Us over there complaining and throwing this man under the bus or throwing the community down under the bus of the lending platform. I ain't lending or the staking platform itself. For you to sit there and say that we're not even evolving and moving forward and not demanding certain things, this game is completely different. A month ago, Lupex was in December. Thorncoin was this year, late January, evolving into what we asking. Don't put those two together. Thorncoin is going to be a coin to reckon with, you know, and future ICOs see what just Lupex did. You think they're going to pull the same stunt with us? We're demanding. We're a bigger team. We're growing. We're being stronger. And I feel for you guys at Lupex. I understand. Capital money's money, man. No one likes to lose money. And I just feel at the end of the day, we just can't put these two together. Don't put these two together. Don't even talk about Lupex and Thorncoin even in the same sentence. It just don't make no – that's like a Mercedes and a Kia, bro. No offense to Kias because they got some nice cars. But we're talking about a whole different level. These people – there's, you know, I think Lupex shut their website down or whatever, didn't tell nobody, and everybody freaked out for a little bit. They came back, you know, and did this last-minute stunt. Thorncoin shuts it out for a day, gives you 2 days in advance that we're going to do some maintenance. Gives you a heads up on staking, tells you that we're going to delay it by 3 days, and then on that third day, open it up with short-term staking. They're doing everything right. We're doing everything right. And if you can't handle this, then you need to just step out of the game and sit on the sideline. Stop messing with these ICOs. Stop messing with these ICOs. Sit on the sideline. Wait till it opens up into the external stage and buy the coin if you feel it's a great coin at whatever low price you can get it at. You know, but to try to come over here and try to rant on these ICOs or try to bring down the stake in future is just absolutely pathetic, man. It's just absolutely pathetic. It's just not your game, and you shouldn't even be in this. So this is your boy Loco for Crypto, just showing you nothing but love, man. Like and subscribe this page, man. I also got the Telegram that I told you on the bottom. Definitely get involved. There's people already there. We're conversating. We were there talking earlier today about the issue today. Let's grow this community. Let's grow all this because, like I said, today we're talking about something. We had a with what just went down, and we need to communicate at all times so that we're able to just see where we're at because Thorncoin's coming. Thorncoin is coming, whether you like it or not. And they understand based on what I show you. What is $3 million to run away with Thorncoin or $4 million? Nothing. Nothing for you to make millions, hundreds of millions of dollars, Thorncoin. And I feel that and they understand that. So this is your boy Loco from Crypto showing you guys nothing but love. Thank you for your support. Like I said, we definitely shot over 700 today. We'll be in 1,000, I believe, sometime next week. You know, I'll definitely be coming next with my next video with the stake. And I really want you guys to see this because I like to put some numbers to it. And Thorncoin has a great chance to come through. And if they do, it's going to make a lot of people a lot of money and they're going to make a lot of money. So Stay your heads up, man. Stay your heads up, man. This is part of the game. We'll get through this, man. Those people are scums. Those people are scums, and we'll leave it at that, all right? This is your boy Loco from Crypto. Stay safe. Peace out.